Excellent. Welcome to Plus Photo Show number 22. It's a full house tonight. Thanks, everybody, for coming in. I'd like to thank Mr. Keith Barrett of the VidCast Network and remind everyone that there is a donate button over on vidcast.com. This isn't free. And thank you very much, Keith, for all you do.
Thank you.
And big news, Mr. Joe Pearson and his lovely wife had a little baby boy this week. So congratulations to you guys.
Thanks so much.
Baby's name.
He's doing awesome. Pretty well.
Another little photographer in the world.
Yeah, exactly. Either that or a kayaker. We're not sure which way it's going to go. His name is Edwin James Pearson. So,
yeah. That's awesome.
Yeah. Photographer to be.
Yeah. There we go.
My friend's about to have a baby, and he's going to fit him in his Canon... I think 500.
Yeah. There's a picture that I saw going around of a baby that just barely fits inside the center pouch of a camera bag.
Oh, yeah.
It's completely propped. Yeah. So they just, you know, like they do in, you know, the crazy poses where the baby's got himself holding himself up or whatever. Well, it's in this guy's camera bag. It's pretty awesome.
Oh, yeah. I've seen that. That is cool.
Yeah.
So welcome to everybody, and why don't we go around quickly and say who we are and where we can find all of you? Okay. Ali?
I'm Ali Alhaj, co-host, and you can find me at certainpointofview.com, and I'm from Orlando, Florida.
Oops, sorry.
I'm Boris Gorelick, and you can find me on Google+.
Eileen McAllister, and the same on Google+.
I'm Helen Stouriadis. You can find me on helenstouriadis.com or Google+.
And Jim Davis, you can find me on Google+ and jimdavis-photography.com.
I'm Keith Barrett. I am now a photographer enthusiast instead of a point-and-shooter. And I live stream... Hangouts on vidcastnetwork.com, predominantly photography right now.
There you go. He's one of us. Welcome to the dark side.
Mm-hmm.
Joe?
I'm Mark Helm. Oh, sorry, Joe.
No problem, man. Go ahead, Mark.
I'm Mark Helm. You can find me here on G+ or mhelm.ca. I'm from Dorchester, Ontario, Canada.
And I'm a fellow Ontariite, if you want to call us that. Joe Pearson from Barrie, Ontario. You can find me here on G+, as well at sounddesign.ca.
And I'm the other co-host, Shane Sergey. You can find me here on Google+ and shanesergey.com, primallens.com, Twitter, Facebook, Tumblr, Instagram.
Posterous.
You can find me.
Yeah. And we've now created a Pinterest for him. And,
yes, and I'm on Pinterest as well.
But you're not on Path yet.
So, welcome, everybody, and let's dive right in. Ali, did you want to tease us with your contest that's coming up?
Oh, it's no tease at this point. I was teasing about it last week. But, yeah, so I was talking to the folks at Topaz Labs, and you know, they put out Topaz Adjust and Denoise and all kinds of good stuff. But... I was talking to them about getting on to Google Plus, and then throughout the conversation, they said, "Hey, you know, do you want to give out some? We have copy Denoise. Would you guys like to have it? You know, give it out as a contest or something?" So, I put up a post today about the contest. Basically, just go download it, create an image using Denoise, and then I have an album that you can upload it to, and we'll pick one. The winner will be announced on May 7th on the show. So it's pretty cool. It's about $80, and I use it on just about every one of my photos. And apparently, Boris doesn't like it. So.
Really? He's off to do the download on his other computer.
Yeah,
he's gonna go check his f-stop rating.
So, yeah, go check it out, and it should be pretty cool. I mean, hey, it's $80, and why not be able to score one for free? So,
yeah.
That'd be cool to take out some of the noise in my iPhone shots.
Yeah, I took some pictures there with iPhone. They came out awesome.
iPhone is awesome.
That's exactly what I've been doing at the hospital. It's just been using my iPhone completely. It's been the best thing. You put it somewhere and you step away. It's been great.
Doesn't Shane have an awesome iPhone site somewhere?
Weapon of Beauty is coming.
Okay.
Very soon. So before we get into PhotoShare, we'll do some conversation first, talk about things that have been going on. So, but I thought there'd be a good theme tonight because we were talking about last week, you know, what our most popular photo on Google Plus was. So if you guys could share maybe an image that you think is the most popular or has had the most plus ones or whatever. And then maybe the shot that you like the most that you put on Google Plus. But we won't do that just yet, just to give everybody a heads up. I did want to preview a little bit of the Sony NEX-7. I know that Allie and Mr. Keith Barrett, you're going to be talking tonight on Trey's show, right?
Yes, I'm supposedly at the 10 o'clock on Trey's hangout on Twit. He's going to, awesome. He's featuring the camera, so that's one of the reasons I'm going to be there.
Right.
Cool.
So let's see. I know it's nearby. You got to do the screen wave. there.
it's got this strap I do not like, so I'm going to have to do something about this strap.
You're going to have to get yourself a Black Rabbit, sir.
Yeah. Well, I have another strap, but you probably wouldn't like that one either. So, yeah. In fact, the camera is so light that part of me is thinking really wrist strap instead of neck strap.
Can you put it in your pocket?
If I take the lens off, I can.
Okay.
I'm sure. Yeah. Hey, Sandy, how's it going? We just started, and we went around and introduced ourselves, so why don't you jump right in and introduce yourself and where we can find you.
Hi, I'm Sandy Skeppis.
Hey, Sandy.
Okay.
Hi, Sandy.
Are you serious? You just started, so I had to be serious.
No, it's okay. We've been joking.
Wildlife photographer, love traveling to Africa, photographing landscape, people, wildlife, involved with some NGOs. And
Kitty.
Living the dream.
Sorry. Mm-hmm. No. If I was living a dream, I'd be over there like all the time.
Jumbo.
Trying, though.
Living the dreams. So have you picked a camera for your next trip to Africa yet?
No. You know, right now I'm actually thinking about putting the house on the market and moving back to the South.
Oh.
Yeah.
So we were just talking Sony NEX-7, 24 megapixels, 10 frames a second. Oh, yeah. Very light.
I'm not switching brands. That's the thing. You know, I stick with it. I'm going to stick with the Nikon. Unfortunately,
you can get an adapter for your Nikon lenses.
Yeah.
So Keith,
you don't like autofocus.
Yeah. Keith. So give us your sense of it and give us your first impression of the camera.
Well, I'm still learning it because this is literally the first digital still camera I've owned except for an iPhone.
Did you buy a lens with it, or did you?
This is the lens that comes with it.
Okay, and so that's like what, the 18 to 55?
Yeah, and I couldn't afford any other lenses, but I showed Ali today too. I have two rather impressive 35 millimeter lenses that I bought an adapter for that hasn't arrived yet, so I'm going to try those out first. And I bought it on Friday, and I've been so busy all weekends. I only spent a couple hours with it so far.
Seriously?
Yeah.
It's a new camera, and you only spent a couple of hours.
Yeah. Well, unfortunately, the taxes had to come first. The taxes were paying for it, so.
That's right.
And yeah, the VidCast network doesn't run itself.
No, it doesn't even supply its own funds yet. So.
Send it to me. I'll try it out for you.
No, well, I ran around.
If anybody doesn't know the rules, we just kind of jump in, so feel free. And
I have some shots I can show you.
Yeah, that'd be cool. Does it go 2.8?
Yeah.
Yes, it does.
It's Boris compatible.
It is Boris compatible.
It's Boris compatible. Yeah, what's the speed? What's the max aperture on that lens?
Oh, I don't know. Can't you look this up on Google instead of making me dig it out?
Yeah, don't ask him.
I have to run a studio at the same time.
Asking the newbie.
For the record, I don't hate it. And also, it's not a Micro Four Thirds, which is Why don't hate it?
Didn't you do a review on it? You should know.
I did do a review on it, and
yeah, I mean
it's not.
My future camera would have been a Micro Four Thirds. I want a mirrorless small camera, but I didn't want to wait another year for the Four Thirds to solidify into what I wanted to be. So
yeah, that's very smart.
This was the best. This is the best thing right now in sort of that genre that exists, even though it's a little more expensive.
Sure. And the Sonys have been around for a while.
Yeah, the only thing I don't like about it is it's locking. You know, it locks me into the E-Lens series, but. Which are not cheap and not universal, but
well, you can put any alpha mount lens on there.
Yeah, if I buy that big honking adapter, it's half the size of the camera. I can do that. Yeah.
That kind of defeats the purpose. That's all right, man. You know, build your lens selection one at a time. You know.
Well, the lenses are the
I'm
same.
I'm guessing the 18-55 will do most of what you want.
The lenses are the same physical size as my 35mm lenses, so, and the adapter is just a ring. I mean, it doesn't have a prism or a lens or anything in it, so I'm going to be real curious to see how that works, because that was only $20. So.
Have you blasted away with it yet? Does it do 10 frames a second?
It does quite a lot of frames a second.
What's it sound like? Does it even make a sound?
Right now, I think I have it in the HDR setting, so it's only going to do 3.
It does make a sound. It sounds like a regular charger.
My battery's almost dead too.
Always keep your batteries fresh.
While I was using it.
So how do you like the two dials in the back?
Well, I'm going to reprogram it. The three dials are programmable, and the way they're distributed by Sony is not very practical. And there are some websites that actually have some ideas how to do it better.
You know,
that thing's all lens.
Lens and camera strap.
Let me see if I can figure out how to change this. Keep talking. Talk amongst yourselves.
I totally need a vertical grip.
Can you show us the back, Keith?
Hold on.
Turn it around so we can see the back. I'm just interested in what this thing looks like.
It's got a built-in flash, by the way, too.
Okay. Awesome.
Awesome.
Those are good, and if you don't know, if you dial your flash back like 0.7
pull
of
out
a stop,
a
it'd be
pull back towards
awesome.
You. That's pretty cool. That's a nice screen.
The viewfinder, the viewfinder is almost 3D. It's incredibly intense, and it switches to the viewfinder when you put it to your eye automatically.
That's what.
And the lens tilts out too. I mean, the screen tilts out, not the lens.
So do you think that it will last, my friend, 6 months on the Pacific Crest Trail?
The way I take
from Mexico to Canada.
Well,
it has an electronic viewfinder and a large honking LCD screen in a small form factor. So he better pack some batteries.
Yeah.
Well, no, of course he's got that. I'm talking about the durability.
I don't know. I take pretty good care of
things. I think it would. It is pretty solid.
Yeah, so it's not. The 5 seems solid.
It's not a plastic body, as far as I know. So.
Nope, it's not. I think it's magnesium.
Yeah.
Which is cool, kind of segues into some of the things that I've been following this week. Technology going unusual places, cameras going, you know, across the continent, iPhones going up to Everest, the top of Everest this year, and Outside Magazine, as well as some other people, are doing daily dispatches from the Everest base camp using iPads. I guess the cell service is now everywhere up to the top of the mountain. And so they're using those devices.
Seriously, cell service reaches up to 29,000 feet.
Yes, can you believe it?
Well, then there's got to be something up there for that.
I know.
There's
got to be a tower somewhere.
and my cell service sucks.
There'd be no tower up near ever. I know.
Yeah, they put cell service in.
How the okay, so that's somebody climbed Everest with it. I mean, how did they get it there? Did they drop it by plane? I mean,
the tower? The tower is somewhere in the valley.
I'm sure somebody sponsored a climb and said, here, if you put the cell tower up there, we'll sponsor your entire climb.
Well, I'm sure the service has to be dependent on the weather systems that come up through that, you know, sure. That's not an easy place at all, you know, so that's interesting.
Yep. And they're doing, they just started the 50th season. This is the anniversary of the Hillary climb. And so Outside Magazine and National Geographic are doing a lot. I thought it was interesting that they're using iPads down in base camp for dispatches. They function better than like a laptop, unless the laptop had an SSD drive. So it's pretty cool.
Interesting.
Interesting to see how they hold up, because I'm very interested in that kind of thing with the iPads. So, since we have a shortened show, we'll be ending at about 9:30. Is that correct, Keith?
Yeah, I have to leave around 9:30.
So let's roll into share. I haven't really seen everybody's work. That's always a great way to get to know people.
Who's up first? Shit. Ali,
I'll do it.
I actually have photos I can share.
ABE.
And Keith, you have to show something from your camera.
Yeah, I have a. I don't have any. They haven't been processed yet, but I have photos.
That's okay.
So this is one I put up today. This is Disney's Convention Center at the Yacht and Beach Club, and of course, this. I think this is like 9 or so exposures. But this one's
what lens did you use?
17-40 f/4 and. Sorry to disappoint you, but this is at f/16.
Yeah, I figured that.
Yeah, and I think I'm focused on that first column on the right.
Yeah, because
I focused on that right up here. If you see that little flag right there,
yeah,
that's where I focused at. And I think I tried two different ones, and I decided that that's probably where the eye's going to go most. So, yeah, that one's been pretty cool. And I'm working on one right now. So after this, I decided to go shoot horses, which were completely uncooperative, and I just did this thing. So I'll probably be posting this one tomorrow, but I'm not totally in love with it, so we'll see. But yeah.
I like the sunset on the main.
Yeah, the rim lighting is really nice on that one.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and that's what I was in love with. It's just... So what I was trying to do, just show you guys, so there was this like amazing sunset going on, and I was trying to get the horse to look at me and get the sun in there, you know, at the right, in the right part of the frame and everything, but that horse just was not having it, you know, he just looked everywhere else. Oops.
Yes, photographing animals is so much fun. You can't make a mistake.
Carrots.
Like, I have a hard enough time with people.
Actually, my friend Monica Stevenson is really, really good at getting a horse's attention. It's pretty amazing.
How does she do it? What does she do?
She can do it with anything. She just grabbed a little bit of grass and got this full-on dressage horse that's, you know, uber trained to, like, you know, focus on her. It was pretty amazing. I need, you know, a whole bag of carrots.
I was tapping my keys at the side on the side of my lens cap, my lens hood. And
yeah, they won't care about that.
No, it would get his attention, but then he was just like, whatever, you're not Andy.
Okay, who's next in pictures before time goes out?
Oriented stuff.
Andy's back.
Hey, Andy, how's it going? You just jumped right into the hot seat, sir.
You're next.
Yeah. Now you have to share a photo.
Yep.
Yeah, let Boris go. I haven't got anything lined up, guys.
Okay.
Thank you.
Give me a little while.
Okay, I got a couple. This is 5 Points, Long Island City. I took this picture a couple years ago. Aline gave me some toys for Nick Software, so that's why it came out so beautiful. Thanks, Aline.
You're welcome.
And this is... from the, my friend's apartment on 31st floor. Took it nighttime. F-stop 8, not 2.8 this time. 30-second exposure.
That was nice.
Thank you.
I love night shooting. I love night shooting.
I love the blue light on top of the buildings.
Yeah.
It took me... I did like 5 different pictures of the same thing, and I think I like this one the best. And I went to Coney Island yesterday. I was... Got the bird. I shot the bird.
You shot him?
Yeah, but he flew away.
Is anybody monitoring the chat room?
I was. There's nobody in it.
Okay.
Ooh. Well, no, sorry. Beauty Bubble's in there now.
And
who is Beauty Bubble? Because she's always in there. Or he.
She's a...
Hello, chat room.
She's a and this person. Is what you call it. Coney Island again. They got me and him will listen to the AD music.
That's pretty cool.
And he had awesome. he was smoking pot. I wasn't. welcome to the 80s.
How would you tell the difference?
We only have your word for that, Horace.
And this is today going from work. There's a Trinity Church by my job, so I took a macro shot.
Good for you.
And that was it.
I'm proud of you.
Macro Monday.
That was 100.
It's totally trending today.
That was a 100 millimeter macro lens, not the L series, the cheap one.
You found the one flower in Brooklyn?
Yes. And it was I found more, but this came out the best one. I'm done.
Andy, you got it?
Andy, anything? Ready yet?
No, keep going.
Okay. Hi, everyone. A little nervous about doing this. this one, Sandy said that she liked about a week ago, and I went on what you said, Shane, of like most popular versus what we like the best. And a lot of people, this was on St. Patrick's Day in downtown Knoxville, Tennessee.
Oh, cool.
And that seemed to go over really well with folks on Google Plus.
It's got a lot of layering to it. That's really nice.
Yeah.
Yeah, I had a lot of fun doing this. I did one thing after another and kept building it up until I got it where I wanted it. And then my favorite, personally, is this one. I just love the way the water came out on that.
That's beautiful.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. It's so still and peaceful.
Yeah, it's just beautiful up there. But that's just a country mouse, city mouse kind of thing. And this was my first attempt with HDR. Boris kind of helped me out with that. I got that. I was out taking some pictures of some old cars on a farm, and this was up in the weeds. And I asked the fella if I could have it, and he said, yeah. And so I took it, and I took some pictures in front of the house, and it came out pretty good. I like it.
Awesome. Yeah, that's a
pretty
cool bike.
Allie, we HDR'd this bike.
HDR'd the bike. So those are my three.
So yeah, the other thing I'm curious about too is like which pictures does anybody have a sense of what plays well on Google Plus that may not play or may play differently on say Facebook? I've noticed that some images grab on Facebook and some images grab on Google Plus.
I think it depends what kind of day it is.
Yeah, I agree.
There's a big nostalgia factor. I mean, nostalgic photos seem to be a really big draw.
Yeah, for sure.
Those and baby, great. Thank baby you very animals. Much. Baby animals always.
Oh, yeah. Definitely.
Cubs and pups and
cats.
Whenever I
post. Baby animals play well on Google Plus?
Oh, yeah. I'm not like one of these, people that get 500 plus ones, but I posted a baby hyena
over the
weekend.
That.
And, yeah, that seemed to be, everybody seemed to love it. And same, I posted the same photo except in black and white. I posted in color on G+ and in black and white on Facebook, and it was well received in both. So, as opposed to, I think the same day I posted an adult hyena that had a wildebeest four-leg in its mouth, and it, you know, got some plus ones, but not as many as the cute little baby hyena did. So.
Yeah, baby cell.
Baby animals.
Yeah.
That's for sure.
You're stirring it up, Sunday.
Hmm? What was that, Andy?
I said, you just like stirring it up.
I know, I do. I still haven't posted that good one with the lion with the zebra in its mouth yet. I'm saving that for a rainy day. So.
Take that.
I can't do that. If I have a good picture, I'm going to post it. I'm not going to wait.
So, Andy, are you ready yet, or otherwise we're...
Yeah, I can so one or two up. I said having one or 200 after not having been around for a while. Is that coming up?
It's up.
Yeah, I can't see it. I see your profile.
It popped up for a second.
Yeah. I can see it in the... You know, we're in the small window, but when I click on it, I see your...
Click again.
Yeah, if we click on your window, it comes up.
Oh, there it is.
Nice.
You're the master.
I love all the lines.
Mm-hmm.
In the field. That's really
very
beautiful.
Very cool, Andy. Very cool.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was... We had a great period of weather. We had record temperatures for March, and then 1 week later we had 8 inches of snow. It was amazing.
Sounds like Colorado.
We went from 23.6 degrees to 8 inches of snow in a week. It was brilliant.
Wow.
And I got out to get just about my first decent snow shots of the winter when we had the snow.
That's killer. If that's the only like good shot you got all winter, that would be well worth it.
People, yeah,
I took this shot on the same day.
Oh, I like that too.
It's beautiful.
I wanted to get a little bit further up the road for this. I can't remember how many shots is in that panorama. There's quite a few. But there's a castle. I don't know if you can see my cursor or not.
Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Right in the center of the shot. And that's what I was trying to... that's what I was trying to sort of, you know, focus on. If there's such a thing as a focus in a panorama. But the snow gates were closed on the road, so I couldn't get any higher up. This was as far as I could go. So at least I got the castle was in sight. But a little bit further up, I would have had a better view of the castle. Another old one.
Nice.
That's no fair. There are no castles in Florida.
Yes, there is. 192's got two of them.
There's sand castles.
There's Disney. Isn't Disney a castle?
Yeah, not even counting Disney. There's two on 192.
There's no... There's what do you mean? Are you talking about medieval times?
That's one of the two, yeah.
Well, that doesn't count.
You said there are no castles in Florida. I was correcting you.
Oh. All right. Well,
okay. Crenellon, you can't forget the biggest, best castle of them all.
Okay. I mean, I'll give you...
Look at that.
This shows you how much I like... Yeah, this one shows you how much I like the day out in the snow. I got another shot. Another decent shot. I don't know why the clouds up here just didn't seem to quite work. That's I think this one's a panorama as well, actually. But for some reason, it didn't quite work up here.
Hmm. But you got 32 passes.
Doesn't really pull the eye away at all.
No. And so shot that just a few days ago. That castle's just five miles down the road. I get a little bit fed up of shooting it, to be honest, but
you take it for granted, do you?
Just a little bit, yeah.
And Andy said you can go inside that castle.
Yeah, you can get inside it as well. It's a good one.
You imagine what kind of fortune you can make in there?
There's some good spots. It would be quite good. I might have a chat with them at some time and see if I can do a photo shoot inside there and get a few models in.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah.
I love the top. The top is awesome.
Yeah.
Like, is that owned by somebody, or is that just Crown's land?
Sorry, say that again.
Is that owned by somebody? Does somebody own that castle?
No, it's Historic Scotland that own it, so it's owned by the state.
Ah, okay.
What else have we got? Oh, no, that's an old one as well. I think I'll stick with that for just now. That way I've got plenty others for the next time come up.
Always keep them wanting.
Yeah.
Leave on that's a high great. Note.
Those are really cool to see. And given that, I'll tell you what, we'll trade you. Since we don't have any castles, we'll trade you some beach shots. So you can get some warm and sunny Florida.
I'm being told that the chat room is having difficulties.
Oh no, chat room!
Yeah.
Okay.
That's why we don't see many people in it.
Hey, Jim, so how's it been going?
Not too bad.
Good.
Finally got my camera back, so I'm able to shoot. I wasn't shooting there for a little bit.
Did you find that frustrating or a welcome break?
Oh, no. It was big time frustrating. Big time. Especially with two cameras on order, it's made it even worse.
But now that
I got the D3X back, it's still an excellent camera. Just because the other ones are out doesn't mean that it's a slip.
If you got the Canon Mark III, you'll have to wait.
Nah. What am I going to do with the Canon?
You can give it to me after you finish it.
But what I did do is I did borrow a friend's camera for a couple weeks.
Did you?
So I was able to get out, and I did some virtual photo walks.
Cool. How did that go?
Pretty good. So we did one when we were up in Bruce Peninsula, but then I did another one in Long Point, Ontario, which is on Lake Erie. And I'll just share just a couple of the a few of the images that I did there. So basically what that is the virtual photo walks is a photographer will go out, and can you guys see that?
Yeah.
Yep.
And take someone who's less fortunate, can't get out, maybe can't get out of their house, and show them the area, some of the areas that you shoot. So this here is on a portion of Long Point along the beach. What I was hoping here was the sun, which was setting behind me, to light up the clouds, but that's pretty much the best that I got on that situation. So once I realized that I wasn't going to get more, I turned around and shot the same log, which is a completely different perspective when you hear the book.
Totally. Even the clouds look different.
Yeah, for sure. So different clouds in behind there. And then when I did the actual photo walk, it was raining out, which was the next day. And so it was a pretty dreary day. So what I did was I turned everything into black and white just to get a little bit more interest, and then started focusing on single things or very, very smaller things within the scene to try and bring more interest in. So this here, just with this twig on the beach.
Yeah, that's awesome.
The next one is some dog prints.
Oh, cool.
Leading out down the beach. That was kind of cool. And then the last one was a shell that I turned black and white and left the shell color. I thought that was quite interesting, and it's in the shape of a heart, the way it lays there. So I thought that was very...
Very nice. Those are great.
You could almost sell that as a butterfly, man.
Oh, Shane, I did. I'm sorry, I did a virtual work myself, and if
did you
guys want, here's a link to it. If you guys want to, it's from YouTube. Cool. You can watch.
Yeah, that's really, it's really an awesome idea. I brought that up to the iPhone photographer was giving a lecture down at Palm Beach Photographic Center, and I said, you know, there's so many different things that are going on, and you know, told him about virtual photo walks, and I think he got a little teary. You know, it's a really great, great project. So
it's fun to. I was nervous to do it at first, but it's fun to do.
Yeah, it is. Imagine.
But you need somebody to be with you because you feel much not safer. You just feel more comfortable to do like your friend to do with you. It just he feels much better. You can't do this by yourself because you go crazy.
Yeah, I almost I would say I almost feel an obligation. As somebody who's able-bodied and can get out whenever I want to do that for people that are less fortunate. I think it's, you know, it's almost a responsibility that some of us should take on, you know.
I've been very frustrated.
I agree. Being able to get out into nature and share that with someone, you know, mm-hmm. That's a really cool thing, as well as an artistic process.
Yeah, and it helps both people, like it. You know, it's good for the person that's doing it because they have more of a purpose. It's not so selfless, or it is selfless, I should say. You know, you're doing it for a good cause.
Yeah, I was very fortunate to be in one of the very first ones with John Butterall and Corey Frisk.
Mm-hmm.
And it was really emotional. I mean, to think that he was in Peterborough walking around and she was in a bed in California. And just to hear the interaction between the two as he shot pictures and she directed them to that tree and this tree and that bush. And it was magic. It really was. Yep. Good stuff.
Very cool. I'm just going to share that with everybody. So Keith,
yeah.
Do you have any shots from your little lovely beauty there?
I do. Let's see what this does to the broadcast when we're doing this here. I have to change. Let's see.
So, and maybe we can talk for a second about the process in getting involved in virtual photo walks.
I think for the most part, if you contact John Butterill, and just discuss with him that you're interested in doing that type of photo walk, and then whenever you're out in a location that you feel is, you know, suitable, that you try and set it up with him and whoever he has lined up that can go.
You know, Keith, we should do that sometime at Disney for somebody, because I know there's a lot of people who can't make it down here. And I know there's a lot of people who may just not be able to make it down here. Yeah. Just physically, I think they would really appreciate that.
Ali, there's a Wi-Fi in Disney?
Not in the parks, in the hotels.
There is, yes. Well,
yeah, because you're going to eat your it's going to eat your data alive on your phone.
Yeah, there's some Wi-Fi that some people have access to, and Keith and I would have access to that. So not everybody can get on all the Wi-Fi, and it's not everywhere. So, but I'm sure we could talk to Disney, and we know some of the social media people.
I always tether my phone. Anytime I go out there, I always tether my phone.
You always tether your phone to the Wi-Fi?
Yeah, no, to my laptop or whatever.
Oh.
So let me, I can show these photos real quick. Let me switch my
cool
broadcast to it too, so the live stream can see it.
Kitty.
Okay. So yeah, that was the very first shot. It was the very first semi-serious shot I took with the camera. It was in the house. I was literally 10 minutes ahead of the camera.
I see that. Are you serious, Keith? Look on her face.
Yeah, I actually and these are the JPEGs. I'm not showing the RAWs, but
that's okay.
This I was playing with the ISO settings. So I intentionally blew out the picture, but I did not expect the expression on her face and the depth of field and the focus, the sharpness on her eyes and her head. So I thought, I got to keep this one. It looked pretty good.
They can't say that you shot me with a Sony, not a Canon.
He says, give me that camera, I can do better.
So these are a couple of shots I did at lunch today. Ollie was with me, so helping me to make sure that I did them right. These are some landscapes out the back of our building, office building.
There's the one. That's the one at F-16, right?
I think so, yeah.
Yeah, I think the other ones were at F-18. I'm like, F-16! F-16!
and then I tried to do a couple of things on my, later as on the way home. So here's a shot from our office. This is our office building.
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah, I thought that came out really good. That's nice. That's our office building looking up at it from the ground. I didn't like the way this one laid out. I shot this one from my car. It didn't come out well. But that gives you an idea what our building looks like.
Is that the front end of somebody's car in that case?
Yeah, it was mine. I was in the car when I took it. And this is actually another shot in my car on the way home. This is some office buildings. And then I went downtown and took the ice cream shop photo. That's our ice cream shop. That's a little fountain area in front of our theater. The theater, unfortunately, I thought it was going to be sharp, but it came out blurred, so I had to figure out what I did wrong there. And a piece of foliage.
Looks like the light was failing, wasn't it?
I don't know. It might have been my depth of field or focus or something like that. I'll have to go take a look at it. I didn't expect it. And I couldn't see through the viewfinder very well because of where I was in the water and everything, so... And then that was the last photo I took, which was by the pond right there.
Very cool. So are you using the live view or are you using the viewfinder?
I've been using both, whatever strikes me at the time. I'm trying to get used to the viewfinder, but I have to smash it against my eyeglasses to use it. So.
You might want to try using the... the screen and see how that works for you.
Yeah. Well, I tend to use the screen to set up the shot, to line it up. Mm-hmm. And then I look through the viewfinder when I'm about to take it, but it's just probably a bad habit to start it with already.
And do you find that the screen is fairly true to the image?
The viewfinder is actually sharper than the screen.
Okay.
But the screen is flexible. And, when the camera's on the tripod, the odds are I'm going to be using the screen.
But did you notice, on the camera, the picture looks all beautiful, but when you bring it to the computer, it looks like not the same?
Yeah. I mean, I knew there would be a difference, though. I said, none of those photos are processed. I dumped them from the camera to the laptop just before the show, so I didn't even know what I was going to be in for.
Cool.
That viewfinder, I have to say, is remarkable. It really looks 3D.
Yeah,
that's what I've heard from everybody. So that must be really interesting.
Cool. It really is. I was blown away by it.
So. Is that one of those digital viewfinders?
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah. There's no mirror in this camera.
So, Mark, we're coming up close. So, Mark, do you have any images to share?
And this is an old one that I had, and it's been my most popular one.
Wow!
What is that?
That's an orchid. It's an orchid from the side.
Wow!
That's funky.
That's gorgeous.
It went like 400 shares, and then I got this, where it got shared by everybody in the world. This is my lottery payoff.
I still see the orchid. Oh no,
it's coming.
No, it told me that my Chrome just crashed.
Oh no, so this got me in Trey's circle apparently, I guess. Mm. So that was.
You're just name dropping now, Mark.
Well, I am. I will never have it again. But have these three guys all in one picture, make a comment. But the one that really has gotten a lot of reaction is this one.
I don't see it.
It's coming.
No.
Are we running out of time?
We've got 3 minutes, so we've got time.
Keep going. I'll give a heads up.
That one's got like 400 pluses on it.
About nice.
80 shears. Mm. That's my nice. Backyard.
Isn't that awesome? Like, yeah, like didn't have to travel nowhere for this one.
I don't have to travel. Most of them I don't have to. They're right out the back door. So those are my two for this contributions.
Very interesting. And do you have a sense of why they were hits, why they were popular? Do you have ones that you've thought that would be, you know, 400 plus ones and didn't take, or?
Well, and I'm not sure why, because, well, maybe it's because my audience is probably fairly specialized,
mm-hmm.
but like my all time favorite one is this one, and it doesn't, you know, it's not popular. I just, some of them, it's just hit and miss, I guess. It's just hit and miss on what the topics are. Spiders seem to really go well. People like spiders. People like the artsy floral stuff.
Yep. Do you think that people like spiders because they sort of like to be scared by them?
I do. I think it's the same as the reaction they get from the snake pictures.
Yep. You know, I almost got an iPhone shot of a black widow the other day.
Almost?
I didn't realize it was a black widow, and I usually wear gloves because we have treated the fences are all treated wood, and I get splinters all the time. So I wear gloves, and I wasn't wearing my gloves, and I'm like, oh, this is a cool spider. Let me get a shot of it. And it flipped over, and I'm like, oh, it's a black widow. Okay, never mind.
Well, I saw
it was like an inch away from my finger.
Really cool picture this week. The guy was taking a picture. He was down on the ground, and he had a field of red flowers out in front. I'm not sure what they are. And he had a rattlesnake put its head up.
Oh, wow.
So he's got this beautiful stage picture of the flowers and everything. And the snake is, like he said, it was like 3 feet from him. Raised up and went into its, looked at him. And he said, we both looked at each other for a second. And then he inched backwards and the snake just dropped down. He didn't know where it went. But
wow.
That'd be the first time me ever laying down in that state again. I'd never lay down ever again.
Yeah, that was Steve Siren's shot, eh?
Sorry?
Steve Siren shot.
Was it?
Yeah.
It was just so dramatic with the red. That was one of the red flowers in the snake, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, it was gorgeous.
Wow, cool. Yeah, I was laying down next to a cottonmouth the other day, but I was like 6 feet away, and it was pretty sleepy. So.
They're aggressive, though, aren't they?
Yeah, it wasn't my favorite thing. But hey, my friend had done it, so I wasn't gonna be outdone.
I see.
Mark, can you show your picture like 8 o'clock in the morning, 9 o'clock in the morning? You're gonna get a lot of hits.
Oh, am I?
That's what I figured. That's when people go wake up and go to work, yeah. Wherever.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, that's why I get the most hits in the mornings.
It's true. I think if you start them early, they get more hits. I post usually around 11, because that's when I'm done with the ranch chores. But that sort of grabs the West Coast feed when they're coming into work. But I think you're right, Boris. Keith, I think, did we run over?
No, we can keep going. I haven't seen anything yet.
Okay. I just didn't want to have to sign out or not sign out. Let me just share a couple of random ones.
I'll give you a heads up when it happens.
From the rodeo.
By the way, I don't know if you saw this or not, but Google's going to come out with a 5 gig drive, network drive,
yeah,
for everybody tomorrow.
Yeah, I wanted
tomorrow,
to talk about
next
that.
Week.
There was a bunch of stuff on tech that I wanted to talk about. Why don't you talk about that for a sec?
I'm looking at it right now. The Next Web is reporting a story. It's not a Google announcement or press release. It was buried in some other stuff with a partner. But that Google's going to release the Google Drive sometime next week. It's going to give 5 gigabytes of free cloud space to everybody. and it works as a folder on Mac, Windows, Android, and iOS.
Yep.
So now Windows?
Yep.
Oh, yeah, Windows.
Sweet.
That'll be cool. They're going to, it's sort of like a Dropbox.
Yeah, it's a bigger Dropbox.
Cool.
Why does Google keep all this storage? That's, I'm curious. Because email, they give like 6-8 gigs.
They have huge disk and computer farms. Mostly, a lot of them sitting in tractor trailer, you know, 18-wheeler trailers, just connected to fiber. They have mobile computer centers that just, you know, they just set them up as boxes and you know, just set them on land. So
I'm really glad you clarified that there. I just had a vision of a tractor and a trailer and a box somewhere.
But they must be all around the world then.
Yep.
Well, they have main data centers that I know of in California and Atlanta and in North Carolina, rural North Carolina. So, and I'm sure they've got them in every major metropolitan area that they do, especially if they do video service too.
Is that for security that they have in the trucks?
We could probably dedicate a whole show to just those data centers. They're so interesting.
That'd be fun.
Yeah, I saw an aerial view of one of Apple's that they're adding on to, and it's just, it's like 10 Walmarts stuck together. It's just this massive complex.
That's expensive, too.
Yep, a $1 billion center, and they're doubling it, so it's going to be another $1 billion they're throwing into it.
And everything in Google is triple redundant.
Wow.
Yay for Google. So here are a couple shots from the rodeo that I photographed last week or the week before.
Rodeos are so cool, aren't they?
They really are.
I mean, you can shoot.
That's cool. So you focus on there, though.
I've never been to one.
Oh, you can shoot tons of stuff and never shoot a horse or a cow. Just the cowboys. Everything else that's going on.
Yeah, completely. I actually was kind of bummed. I got scheduled to cover all the events, and the other photographers were kind of grousing because they wanted to shoot, you know, like the Bronx, like I'm shooting here, and the Bulls, and I'm like, yeah, but you guys are free to just shoot everything, you know, like you're saying, Mark, like shoot the whole thing, you know. The one of my friends got a couple kissing, and they're both rodeo, part of the rodeo, and she's got her cowboy hat on and he doesn't, and turns out that he proposed to her that night, so this is going to be like, you know, part of their history together. It's this really iconic kind of shot. This one was almost done out of necessity because the bronc riding is so much like a roller coaster that there's no way to keep it in focus. You know, it's just like it takes off. This bronc takes off like a rocket, and so I focused on the people, and I wanted to get their reaction. They really do these events for each other, and these are all different riders, and you can see the one guy's injured. There was so many guys with arm injuries, it was pretty amazing. So, and the way the light was lighting up their straw hats was just awesome.
Yeah, it was the light in that shot.
Yeah, that was the other thing too. It was really started to get challenging. It was from 7 to 9 p.m. and once the sun dropped down, the big floodlights weren't enough, really, especially when the fast are moving. I was wishing the Bronx were earlier in the evening.
Yeah. But the light on those hats is gorgeous. I
mean, yeah, it really makes it.
I found with the Bronx, the same with the Bulls, if you watch them, they pretty much go in the same sort of direction, and I just kind of set up and focus on a spot and wait for them to hit the spot.
Yep, that's what I did.
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. You can shoot the whole day and never take a picture before or anything.
I have to try that one day.
This is a great shot. This a shot with my 300. And he was one of the guys that – there was two guys that would rope the Bronx if they once the rider was either thrown off or they would help the rider dismount.
Rescue riders?
Yeah. So he.
I love that shot. That is a great shot.
Yeah, they're usually senior guys that look like stupid Marlboro commercials.
Yeah, totally. And I've actually got – I don't think I've shared that one, but I've got one guy that was – really running the rodeo. I'll have to post that tomorrow. That he's actually smoking a cigarette, and he's pretty much he's smoking a cigarette because he's got the calves in the chute, and so he's pretty much kind of just has the cigarette there to kind of kill the smell from the cattle, right? It looks like you'd swear it was out of the 50s. You know, you couldn't tell that it was from, you know, 2 weeks ago.
Guys, I will see you next week, okay?
All righty, Boris. Okay.
All right, Boris.
Bye.
So let's...
easy, Boris.
Bye. See you, Boris. Bye-bye, guys.
So before we sign out, does anybody have anything to talk about that's coming up?
No.
All righty.
Not much. No, nothing new this week.
Excellent. Oh,
one thing maybe that, I mean, it may be too bad Joe's not here, but there's a photo walk coming up in Toronto on the weekend of the May 25th, and it's actually going to take place on a Saturday. So for anybody that's in Canada watching or listening, that might be something you want to put on your calendar.
Where are they going to go?
Pardon me?
Where are they going?
Well, we're going to start at Nathan Phillips Square at the Toronto City Hall. And we're going to hang out in the vicinity there and get some shots of the city. And then we're going to head down towards Lakeshore and take the ferry out to Ward's and Algonquin Island and shoot the skyline at night.
Well, that'd be great.
Yeah.
You going anywhere near Chinatown?
That's a possibility. The thing we have to work out is the logistics. And it's not that far away, but it would make the walk about a... anywhere up to 10 kilometers, so we have to make sure that we can either use streetcars or that everybody's able to do it. Yeah. But yeah, definitely Queen Street, Spadina, Dundas, Spadina in that area, and then down to Lakeshore.
Yeah, as soon as you start changing locations, I know when we do any workshops, we lose like one or two people, and it's wrangling students. So
yeah. Mm-hmm. We may, possibility we could split up into two groups depending on how many people come, but just keep your eyes out for it.
Well, very cool. Yeah, I'll definitely share that when I see posts for it.
Mm-hmm.
Awesome. Well, thank you. Yep.
This is not really something coming up, but, you know, if anybody can help with this, would be great. I'm doing a little bit of research on ghost towns, and I'm looking for ghost towns in Florida. So I'm looking to do a workshop where we can go into some abandoned buildings and whatnot. So if you have any information on that, definitely send it my way because it's something that I'm actively looking for right now.
Well, I've got one that's might fall into that category. There was a competitor to, I believe, I don't know the specifics that much, but there was a competitor to NASA maybe.
Okay.
Or for the rocket program back in the 60s, and it's down in Everglades, and it's near Miami or outside of Miami, I believe. And
what is it called?
They lost the contract, so they literally. I'll find out. A friend of mine had done some research for me on it, so they lost the contract and they literally shuttered the place, like as is. So it's just been sitting in the Everglades since the mid-60s.
You know, there was a television series in the mid-60s starring Andy Griffin about a junkyard guy who built a rocket that went to the moon or the space program.
Huh.
Yep.
Three
Yeah, that would be that. I mean, that for me is exactly right up my alley because I'm, you know, very much into the space.
Yep.
The space program and just for the kind of shooting that I do. that would just be perfect. So I'll hit you up on that for sure.
Okay, yeah, I'll dig that email up and find out more about it.
Cool, thank you.
You might even be able to Google, like, abandoned space complex.
I might want to go.
Miami.
Yeah, I found a, there's a website called ghosttowns.com, and it's just like ghost towns by state and then by region of state, but it's not very well organized. But it is there, so I'll ask on there as well. Yeah, Keith, I'll keep you posted. What I'm hoping to do is take 5 or 10 people out there. I've had a couple of requests for workshops, and I've had requests also for, you know, just HDR workshops. I've had beginner and HDR folks who are saying, hey, you should do a workshop, you should do a workshop. And I don't want to do something just kind of, you know, one of the mill like we normally do, you know, local, kind of boring. You know, you've walked here 50 times and I do something different. So
I'll keep it's all new to me now, so I don't care.
That's right. You're one of us.
Yeah.
Resistance is futile. All right, guys. Thanks to everybody for joining us for Plus Photo Show number 22. Keith, do you need to set up a sign out, or can we just...
We can just say goodbye, and I'll just push the button.
Okay. All goodbye, right. Good night, and happy shooting, and we'll see you next week.
All right.
Take care, everybody.
Good to see you all.
Well.
Bye-bye.
All right.